Newton second law, we got the formula F is equal to ma. Okay, based on this problem we can do many problems. So let us take find the force. I will give small example how to calculate. Okay, find the force. M is equal to 5 kgs. Next, A is equal to 2 meter per second square acceleration. Find the force. The particle is moving with velocity 2 meter per second square. It has mass 5 kgs. Then what is the force? Find the force. F is equal. What is the formula? M is equal to how much is there? 5 kgs. Next, A is equal to how much is there? 2 meter per second square. Then what happened? F is equal to, find to how much? 10. What is there? Kg meter by second square. Kg meter by second square is equal to how much? 1 newton. Then F is equal to how much force? 10 newton acting on that object. Like that we can solve the many examples. So next I am going to tell about that on the Newton law. Okay, if there are cases cases will be exist. So what happened? Let us take a thread, tie something on one end. Okay, another end you can hold. What happened if you apply the force? What happened? Simply it is revolving. What happened? The radius is fixed. So what happened? Simply it is revolving around this picture point. Okay, if you leave, what happened? It will go different directions. So here F is equal to, what is the formula? Ma. In case F is equal to 0 and next A equal to 0, automatically F equal to 0 means what happened? Acceleration also will become 0. So what happened then? If F equal to 0 and A equal to 0, then it stands to Newton's first law. It states as to first law. This is a positive point. Next, the Newton's second law also we can call the vector's law. Vector law also we can call Newton's vector law. Okay, so the vector law means what we can say. You might have studied about the vector in the first chapter. So we are having now our particle may be in the two dimensional or three dimensional or one dimension. So a particle, let us take, this is the three dimensional shape, this is the x axis, y axis, then this is the z axis. What is this? This in this direction, what happened? Can I write here I vector, J vector, K vector. So what is our formula? F in the x direction. Then what we can write? What I said here? K into d p x by, what we can write? Dt. Why? Because this is in the x direction. Then this equal to what we can write simply? K into m a x. This is one formula. Next, what we can write? Or else if you remove the already you know k is equal to how much? 1. Then what happened? Fx is equal to m ax. Okay, this is in the x direction. Next, similarly, then what we can write? Fy is equal to k. So in here how many directions the forces existing in three dimensions? What is the first one? Fx is equal to m ax. Next, Fy is equal to m ay. Next, Fz is equal to, and Fz is equal to m az. Okay, like this we can use the any formula. This x you should write on the suffix of a, this y also you have to write the suffix of a, this z also you have to write the suffix of a. Okay, in this way we can denote that vectors also, second law. Next one.
So next one, the second law we can apply into the particles, on the particles also. So their particle, how the particle is moving from one place to another place, how much force is acting on that, we can write, we can tell. So we are writing here, what is that? F is equal to ma. What is that? This ma, mass. What is the a? Acceleration. So the acceleration due to what, that we are going to see. Sometime one object is there, let us take, I have thrown one ball. What happened? It went like this. Again, what happened? Or else it will go like this. Then again, it is coming back. Supposed to stands like that, but what happened after some time? Again, it is reaching to the ground. Okay. Why it is coming to ground means, suppose it went like this. The particle has some velocity in a certain direction. Suppose if I consider x direction, y direction. Then why it is coming means, we can consider the A equal to Z. Then what we can write here? F is equal to mg. So in your textbook, another problem is given. Now I am going to tell about that problem.